Hello everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel. Thank you so much for stopping by. Today I have an exciting video because the long-awaited marketplace for PayHip has finally launched. If you've never watched any of my PayHip videos, I will leave a link to the PayHip series so you could go ahead and check it out. But today's video is going to be exploring the new marketplace, checking it out, and just encouraging you to go ahead and put your product on the marketplace if you haven't done so already. If you log into your PayHip account, this is what you're going to be welcomed with. This pop-up that says the marketplace has been launched, and of course you can view the marketplace. So we're going to go ahead and click on that to see what it looks like. Here's what it looks like. Nothing really fancy. Right here, we can see the PayHip Marketplace logo. You can search for products here. At the top, we have the different product categories. As of right now, you can only sell digital products on PayHip Marketplace, but that might change in the future. We are welcome with some featured products right here. Down here, we have explore categories, which of course has different categories that are currently available. PayHip watched one of my videos where I mentioned that some of my product categories were not currently available, and she told me to send them an email and they will put it on their list of product categories to add in the future. So if you are facing the same problem, go ahead and send them an email so your product can be saved in the current category. All right, so let's see what it looks like when we click on one of these featured products. I'm gonna go with this one right here. Here it's what it's looking like. The market logo still shows up right here, and you can still search for products in the marketplace here. When you scroll down, you do feel like you're in the seller space. Shop page, homepage branding showing up like you are in this seller's website. And when you scroll all the way down, it looks like it's recommending additional products from this specific seller. So let's click on one more and see what it looks like. Yeah, we are in this ecosystem of the seller, which I think it's really nice. Now I'm going to click on the PayHip logo just to go back to the marketplace. And what I want to do now is test the search function. I'm going to type in Canva templates because I do sell Canva templates and my templates are currently listed in the marketplace. So I want to see if it shows up when I search for it. None of the suggestions are my products, but I will go ahead and click enter and see what shows up within the search results. It looks like it's a little bit slow though. So as you can see, it is taking some time to load. So that's something that I have noticed, is that so far the website is slow. I'm not really sure why. I don't think it's my computer because none of my other pages are loading really slow, but this is just something that I noticed. Let's take a look at the results. So nothing is showing up when it comes to Canva, nothing at all. And I'm going to see if I can narrow down the results by using the categories here. And I believe mine is saved under design. And there's a subcategory for Canva. I just need to find it here. So under graphics, I'm going to search for assets and templates. So here are the results for that. None of my templates are showing up here. Okay, so now I'm going to try to just search here. Design, graphics, click on that. And let's do mockups. I do remember using mockups for one of my categories. And of course, mockups has Canva specifically, as well as other design programs. So this makes sense. So I'm going to click on Canva and see what shows up. Right here, you can see we have popular tags. So Canva template is a tag, Canva mockups, ebook, etc. Okay, so here's what it's looking like. It looks like it's organized by featured products and by highest rated products. I want to go ahead and click on view all to see what shows up. We have 182 results, and here's my template. I have a few templates that are already showing up on the first page. The other thing I want to point out is the size of the thumbnail. As you can see, it cuts it off right here, so it's not showing everything in the middle. This is a little bit better, but it does still cut it off here and here. So I might need to play around with mockup designs to see what works best for the website. Okay, so let's keep going. I'm just scrolling all the way down, and I am seeing a lot of my templates showing up, which is nice. And all of these are Canva templates. Let's see if we can filter by tags. So if I were going to use coaching template as a filter, I make a lot of coaching templates, so I want to see what shows up. And yeah, most of these are my templates, actually. I would say 100% of the templates that show up here are my templates. Yes, I haven't seen any other template. I make a lot of templates for coaches, and basically by using that tag, it brought up all of my templates. You can filter by price here. I do have a free template, so I wonder if it's going to show up. Yep, my freebies show up here as well. And then you can filter by ratings and stuff. Finally, let's check out your library. Here's what it's looking like. I don't have any activity because I haven't used this demo shop to buy anything. If I click on this icon here, this looks like your account area where you can go into your own shop settings, your wish list, your favorite products from other sellers. You can go back to the marketplace here. You can switch to dark mode and switch your account from customer to creator. So obviously, because I am in the marketplace, by default, customer is checked. I'm going to go back to store and we're back to my shop. By the way, this is not my real PayHip shop. This is my demo shop. It's what I use to create tutorials for my YouTube videos. Let's check out the marketplace from the demo website. We'll click on products. Here are all my demo products, and I'm not going to add them to the marketplace, but I'll show you the steps that you need to take to do so if you haven't started the process. To add a product to the marketplace, you need to edit the product. So you click on edit, click on categories and tags, select the category here, add your tags, save changes. Other way to add your products to the marketplace, especially if you have a ton of products, is click on marketplace and click on bulk editor. Then you can select all products or a specific product. So if I select specific products, a list of my products show up. If I select specific collection, a list of my collections show up. And then what I can do is click on a specific collection, for example, Canva mockup templates up here and click on edit marketplace category. And then I can add Canva and Canva mockups, for example, and save. Or I can click on edit marketplace tags and add or remove tags. This makes it easier to edit a bunch of things at the same time. So I would recommend this if you have a ton of products in your shop, but if you have a few products, you can go in one by one and add the tags and add the specific category to submit the item to your marketplace. My final thoughts on the marketplace is that I do, of course, think it's a good idea. Potentially might bring more sellers to my shop, and it doesn't take away from my personal branding and my own personal website that is hosted on PayHip. The two things that I think so far needs to be worked on, one would be the categories. We need more categories because this does not cover all of the different types of digital products that can possibly be sold on the marketplace. And number two, it's lagging. So I'm not really sure what's causing the lagging, but right now the website is a little bit slow. All right, so that's all I have for this video. Tell me what your thoughts are. Do you think this is a great idea? Let me know, and I will see you in the next video. Take care.